and sister. Keep on loving your children. She's always got a smile on her face. She don't know a lot of times she's my focal point in my messages. When you give them messages, they teach you public speaking. You gotta have focal points. You look to the left, you look to the center, and you look over here. Then you go back to the center, and then you back over here. But every time I look, she smiles. Said the Lord sure is good to her. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Keep on smiling, sister. Jesus is real. He's the reason for all of us being here. He's the reason. I look back here and see Sister Wright, how she's always praying, giving God the glory. Every time I'm up there, I look down here, she said, hallelujah. Hallelujah is the highest praise. Hallelujah out there. Hallelujah over here. Hallelujah in your home. Hallelujah in the schoolrooms. Hallelujah at your job. Hallelujah! How can you say that, minister? You just lost your loved one. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! So I'm telling you to quit preaching. Stop playing your music. Stop doing this and stop going. He's trying to kill us. Right. But God is greater. He's greater. He's greater. Worship the Lord. Honor Jesus Christ. Get rid of it, Jesus. heavy load. Would you carry it for me, Jesus? Help me, because I'm helpless. Strengthen me, because I don't have no strength. Father,
spirit, if you're in contrition right now, you
just right for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 Just right for him. So ask the Lord, if you haven't already, ask him to go home with you. Show him you're his way. That's the way you want to know.
Yeah.
That way you know how to deal with your brother, how to deal with your passerbys on the street. But the Lord's saying, you're our chosen generation.
Amen.
We're different. We are not to be labeled as average. The Lord has invested too much in us.
Yeah.
He invested a great deal, so we ought to give him his return.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Don't you want to give him his due? Give him the glory. Give him the honor. He's worthy of it. He's worthy of it. Don't you love him?
Yes, sir.
I love the Lord. He heard my cry.
Yes.
I love him, and I'm determined to live my life to and for him.
Yes,
in spite of whatever it comes in the flesh, something's going to come. But saints, just know and be rest assured that anything that comes into your life, it's there by permission.
Yes,
isn't that awesome?
Yes,
it's got to get permission to come into your life. Who does he got to ask? Jesus. The one true Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He's got to get permission by him. So if the Lord allows it, it's for your betterment. It's for you to develop, to become stronger, to understand and know him and the power of his resurrection. Because we already were dead. We died with him. So you got to get to know how he resurrected you. Get to know his power and the depths of it. Because it is deep. So the more you learn, the more you learn, the more you know, the more you will grow. And that's what's important. If I don't ever preach again, I got a relationship with Jesus Christ that no one can take away from me, and I cherish it. It's sacred to me. I hallow it, and I praise his name as long as I live. His name will forever be in my mouth. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless his wonderful name. That's the name every Christian, every believer should pray and praise and honor. I often look at Mormons and how they ride in 10-speed bikes, and they got those ties on them. Shirt, helmet. I seen the boy. It was sad. And they was getting their backpack on, keeping up with cars, riding through. And I looked at that and I saw myself. I said, man, am I bold to my calls like that? I mean, people were laughing at them, making fun of them, but they was about their business. Going and riding, you know, they ain't worried about being laughed at. They didn't even worry about getting hit by cars. But I look at how real our Savior is, how real our Father is. And I said, Lord, help me. Help me. Help me to be bold to my cause the way they are to theirs. And that's all. That's what God is wanting in this day and age. Because people are getting bold. Spirits are getting bold. And you got to realize what's being used, what's using a person. You can look at a person and like, man, they're tripping today. No, that's just a spirit. It's a spirit, and you got to pray for them. Pray for them, because somewhere each one of us trips sometimes. You know, so ain't nobody perfect. We all trip from time to time. But when that spirit raises up, you got to stand against it. Especially in preachers. You got to stand against it. You can't let it do you like to do you any kind of way. Preacher got to be mindful of what he's saying, how he treat God's people. Get his objective up. He gets subjected real quick. Well, I thank God for Jesus. You enjoy the word?
Yes.
I enjoyed the message myself. You enjoyed it. You preached it. I received it too. The Lord is looking. There's plenty of places to stand for Jesus. Out there. We're not the shaker, the salt of the shaker. We're the salt of the world. Ye are. Do you light your candlestick? But don't hide it. Don't hide it. Put it up. You can look at this government, how it's failing. Look at how everybody's wanting rights. Look at how even science is over a time frame. We have got off into, they teach us in school, modernization, which deals with scientific facts, which is called evolutionary. It used to be theory, but now it's evolutionary fact. And time to time, they scientific breakthroughs prove that coffee is good for you, not coffee bad for you. Scientific breakthroughs prove that this is good for you, not bad. And they realize over time that they keep having to experiment and explore and keep learning, so they can't keep changing. So they went from modernization to post-modernization. Now for post-modernization, they doing like they did back in the Book of Judges. Did whatever was right in their own eyes. Well, you do your truth and I do mine. You ever hear people say that? I don't want you. I know, man. If you don't know Jesus, you don't know the truth. Period. Period. If you don't know God, you don't know the truth. You know a lie. And it's going to forever change. A lie is never the same. It's never the same. But I thank God for Jesus, because you can look at how people want their rights, gays want their rights. Next thing you know, different ones will be like, well, I want to go back to polygamy. Then they're going to fight for that right. Look at pedophiles fighting for their rights. It's sick, but it's happening. See how dark the world is getting? It needs a light. It needs a light. It needs a light. God said, you are the salt of the earth. Preserve it. Pour your salt on some meat. Keep it bacteria from getting in. Keep them other spirits from getting in. Testify. Tell them how to come, where to come. But most of all and important, live your life as unto Christ. Pleasing unto him. That's the good word. Don't relish on the good part so bad. That's the good word. When you live your life as unto Christ. How do I do that, Minister? Before you go off into something, lean your own understanding. Pray. I just want to show you how and when and what to do. And he'll do that. But you got to trust him. You got to trust in him. And you got to accept that answer. You get it, even if you don't like it. Amen? I thank God for Jesus. I thank God for you sitting patiently through the word. I was praying that more would come. But then again, I say, Minister, you didn't invite nobody. So I asked the Lord to help me. Help me there. I'm going to do better.